Yep, the time has come, folks. The time has come for the final review in the Arnold Schwarzenegger series. First of all, I want to thank everybody for sticking around this long. I hope that you have enjoyed all the reviews and rants up until this point. And now is the last one, and this is definitely going to be a rant slash review. There will be everything in this. And I'm talking about Arnold's latest film. This movie, first of all, I do have it on DVD and Blu-ray, which I'll show. I don't even know. I honestly don't know how I feel about this movie. Sabotage. Yes, I did pick up the Blu-ray DVD combo pack. I know what some of you are thinking, why, but I will admit I liked Arnold in the film. I know a lot of people did not like his performance, but I liked how he played an anti-hero. He was playing a different kind of character. I enjoyed that. That's probably the only thing I enjoyed from this movie. Everything else fucking sucked. And I saw it in theaters too, and it fucking sucked in the theaters. But I didn't want it to suck. I remember coming out of the theater and I'm like, what the fuck did I just watch? Because I didn't know what I watched. Because the fucking trailers lied. But honestly, what do you come to expect, you know, from Hollywood? With all these fucking superhero movies and these fucking remakes and reboots and reimaginings and endless pointless fucking sequels and movies based on true stories and movies based on books. What the fuck do you come to expect from Hollywood? When they try to do something different, they fucking fuck it up and they change it around and they lied. In the words of De Niro from Copland, they blew it. This movie could have been awesome. This movie could have been a balls to the wall old school action film. But no, apparently that was too fucking hard to do. They had to go the Rob Zombie route. They had to go the mystery route. Everything's got to be a fucking mystery. This isn't Scooby-Doo. There is no monsters running around the park. At the end of the movie, Arnold didn't unmask the monster. And the guy didn't say, I would have got away with it too, if it wasn't for Arnold and the stupid dog. No! But then some of you are thinking, well, why the fuck did you get the Blu-ray? Because of that guy. That's why I got it. Because of him. Because I liked Arnold in this movie. That was it. He was like the only good thing about this movie. And I hate to break it to you folks, but it's not an action film! There was what? Six scenes of action? And when there is action, this is what you get. That's what you get when you watch the movie. You can't see what the fuck is going on. Or, you know, you get the stupid CGI, or you get the stupid digital camera shots where the camera's here and I walk away. Or the camera's here, and then it comes to here, and then it goes to there, and then it goes to there, and then it goes to here, and then it goes to there, and then it goes this way, and then it comes that way, and then it jumps up here again, but then it comes over here, and then it zooms in here, and then it goes there, and then it goes right there, and then it goes back to where it's supposed to be after everything is fucking over and you don't know what happened. And when they're shooting, you get fucking CGI bullet hits, you get CGI sparks, you get CGI blood. You get CGI explosions. oh, but this is an action film, right? The trailers said it was an action film. The TV spots said it was an action film. The Red Band trailer said it was an action film. I don't remember that much action in this movie. And I sure as hell don't remember Arnold doing much action in this movie. Until the end of the movie. That they went back and changed, which I'll get into later. But I don't get it. I really don't get it. I don't... What happened to action films? Just like wrestling. What happened to wrestling? What happened to music? What happened to television? Why does everything have to be realistic? It's real. It's got to be real. This is real. It's got to be real. Last time I checked, it's a fucking movie. Doesn't have to be real. It's a movie. Because we get shit like this. We get shit like Expendables 3. We get shit like Bullet to the Head. We get direct-to-video shit. That is not good. We get shit like Die Hard 5, which I like, but it needed a lot of work. Mostly from the directing. Because John Moore cannot direct to save his fucking life. I don't get it, folks. If you can explain to me what happened in the past 10 years or so with action films and everything else, please let me know, because I don't know what the hell happened and I lived through it. Have people forgotten how to write action films? Have people forgotten how to direct action films? Have people forgotten how to film properly without this shit? And without this, and that, and this, and here, and there, and this way, and that way, and here, and there, or... How hard is it to keep the goddamn camera still? How hard is it to apply practical blood squibs on people? How hard is it to film a practical explosion? How hard is it to put squibs on something so you can create sparks and bullet hits? Where did all this go? It worked for 60 years. Why all of a sudden did they change it? I don't know. Again, if someone can explain this to me, please feel free, because I don't know what the fuck happened. Do I blame Arnold? I don't know. Should I blame Arnold for this movie? Or should I blame fucking Skip Woods, who cannot write to save his life? Or should I blame David Ayer? I don't get it. Stallone? Oh, God, I'm not even going to get started on Stallone. Bruce Willis? I'm not going to get started on Bruce Willis. Seagal and Van Damme? I don't know why Hollywood does not like them. Dolph Lundgren? I feel bad for Dolph Lundgren. Why do they not give Dolph Lundgren a chance? I don't know. Why don't they give Scott Atkins a chance? Tony Jaa, honestly, folks, The only good Tony Jaa movies was the first Ong Bak and the first Protector. The Ong Bak sequel sucked. The Protector sequel sucked. Vin Diesel is playing fucking trees now. In fucking comic book movies. They're never going to make a XXX3. I know they said they were. It's never going to happen. And they're going to keep making 900 Fast and the Furious movies. So you can forget about that. The Rock is like the only guy that I care about now. But Skip Woods. Like, does Skip Woods know how to write? I'll get more into that later. Does David Ayer know how to direct? I mean, Street Kings was good. I don't know about End of Watch. I haven't seen it yet. I'd like to. But I don't know. I don't know. And at this point, I don't fucking care anymore. But I'm already, I don't even know how long this video is, but I might as well get into this fucking movie and get it over with. Sabotage, it was fucking known as Breacher and 10 prior to being known as Sabotage. I don't know why they called it Sabotage, because nothing got sabotaged in the movie. There was no sabotaging whatsoever. None. I don't remember it. They should have called it 10. Because 10 people get killed or whatever. Breacher, because it's Arnold. But whatever. I don't care. Sabotage. Okay, Sabotage. Calm down, Fab. It'll be okay. Sabotage is the story of Arnold Schwarzenegger's character, John Wharton, whose nickname is Breacher, because everyone in this movie has to have a nickname. So they call it Arnold Breacher. He's a leader of this special ops team of DEA agents. And the movie opens. They go on this mission. They raid this this mansion where, like, this drug cartel's having a party. And they go against their orders and they steal $10 million of the money. And they hide it in the sewer. One of the guys gets killed. He gets shot in the neck and, like, blood shoots out. I think it was CGI. I don't fucking care. So, they steal this money. They made this decision to steal this money, and they're going to split it up. And they're going to blow up the rest of the money so they can make it look like nothing happened. So they go to retrieve the money, and it's not there, and they're all pissed and upset and everything. And their boss finds out about it, and then they do these stupid scenes where it looks like it was shot with a video camera, where the camera's, like, right here, and they're interrogating them. He was a fucking Navy SEAL. He died. Yeah. We know you took the money. They're gonna keep killing women and children unless you have people like me. I quit. Fuck this. They're interrogating everybody. Because they think they took the money, which they did, and you see it in the fucking movie. It's not like they didn't show it, you know. They clearly took the money. So everybody gets suspended because they don't have proof and everything. So Arnold does his thing, and these guys are watching him because they think he masterminded the whole thing. So he goes to work one day, and his boss pulls him in and says, you guys are reinstated. You know, they closed the case because it's over. There's no evidence, blah, 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 this and that. I know I'm missing stuff, but I'll get to that later. Not actual plot, but scenes. I'll get to those later because I want to talk more in depth and more frustration later with those scenes. So Arnold's team gets reinstated. They're all fucking around and acting like fucking morons, acting like buffoons. So they start training, And they're all arguing and they can't get along. And Arnold's like, come on! We got a team! So they do that. And the one woman on the team, Lizzie, she's an undercover coke whore, but she really is a coke whore. And she's fucking using drugs. And she's like pissed off at Arnold. Go play daddy somewhere else. I'm fine. I don't need you. Ugh. She got on my fucking nerves. All right, baby. Come on, baby. Let's go, baby. Let's kill him, baby. Let's do some drugs, baby. So they go out one night and they all get shit-faced at a strip club. And they beat up security guards who were doing their fucking job because they were acting like idiots. And they leave. And one of the other guys gets killed. Like someone parked his trailer on a train track. And he's too fucking stupid to kick out the door or shoot out the window so he could get away. So he gets killed. And this cop shows up, Olivia Williams and her partner. And Olivia Williams got on my fucking nerves too. Y'all need to find out who killed these people. I'm not making fun of people from the South, but her accent came and went because one minute she's like that and then the next minute she's like, we need to find out who took the money. Well, I think Arnold took the money. We need to go find out who took the money. I think he took the money. Just tell me who took the money. Well, what do you mean he didn't take the money? Y'all ain't from around here. And her partner, I didn't care for her partner. Harold Perneau. I guess that's how you say his name. I didn't care for him. So they get assigned to the case. They go and there's practical blood and makeup effects which look good. Arnold fucking shows up out of nowhere. He was my man. What happened? Why he die? So one of the other guys, he leaves. He like quits. They go to find him and he's nailed to the ceiling and his guts are all hanging out and everything. And Arnold's like, well, I know who it is. It's the cartels. They want the money. They want to know who took the money. So they go to visit another guy. He gets killed, which they did a flashback scene, which I thought was cool how they did that. That was interesting. And they did like the Doom shot, the first person shooter. That was cool. I will admit, I like that. So they find him dead. He just got shot up and they find a couple of the assassins dead, and Arnold finds out they work for this cartel because they have this tattoo. So they start working from there. He had a cell phone, so they start tracing that. So Sam Worthington's character, Monster, he goes and visits Olivia Williams because Olivia Williams thinks that Arnold took the money and everything, which, spoiler alert, he does. Which was a surprise to me. When I saw the movie, I'm like, what? Arnold took the fucking money? Wasn't expecting that. But anyway. So she thinks Arnold took the money and started killing everybody. Which in the original cut, which I'll get to, he did. So Sam Worthington shows up. And he tells Olivia Williams that they arrested this cartel guy. One of the cops got paid off, killed him. They kidnapped Arnold's family. They videotaped him. They tortured his family. And they shot his wife in the head and everything. They killed the son, but you don't see it. And they mailed parts of them to Arnold along with the video. So Arnold went to Mexico and tried to find him. And he couldn't find him. And he killed a bunch of people. So Arnold goes into creep mode for a little bit, and he spies on Olivia Williams, who's swimming in her pool naked, which I didn't notice when I saw it in theaters, but I downloaded the movie before it came out on DVD so I could prepare for this review, and then I picked this up. Actually, my mom got this for me, which was nice of her. So my mom actually bought that, not me. But it was still nice of her to get me that because she knew I wanted it. And that's, that was when I didn't, like, when I when I lost my job and didn't have money to get DVD, my mom got it for me, which was nice of her. So anyway, so Arnold goes into creep mode, and he's, like, creeping on Olivia Williams, who's naked in her pool, which I thought was kind of weird. I know it's at night and shit, but that was kind of weird. I didn't notice she was naked when I saw it in theaters. When I watched it at home, I saw a nipple. I'm like, oh, she's naked. That would make this even more awkward. So she apologizes to Arnold, and they have sex, which was weird. You don't see it, which was good. On here, there's a deleted scene where you see Arnold naked in bed, which was even more weird. Arnold, 60-some years old. I don't want to see his ass. Sorry. That's weird. So they get a number. They trace the cell phone number. And Olivia Williams sends it to Arnold, and him and his team go there, and it's a safe house for the drug cartel. And they have another shootout in there, and they find drugs. And Lizzie is, like, doing drugs, which I thought was fucking stupid, because you're a DEA agent! Drug Enforcement Agency! And you're doing drugs? How fucking realistic. Good job, Skip Woods and David Ayer. Good job on a shitty script. So they go there, they kill all these guys, and they're like, well, Arnold's like, well, see if it's them. And Sam Worthington's like, it's not them. And he's like, check again. And Sam Worthington looks down, he's like, yeah, it's not them. And I thought that was funny. That was, like, the one funny line in the movie. So they end up finding him later in the river near where they killed the guy in his house. And, like, they do an autopsy and they find out they got killed before everybody else. So they're framing the cartel, which does not make any fucking sense. Sorry. So Arnold, like, has a meeting with his team, and Arnold has a fucking hoodie on for some reason. It just looks so weird and out of place. Like, Arnold has never worn a hoodie in any other of his films, but all of a sudden, you get the picture? Someone is killing us. We need to find out who it was now. Like, you understand? So, Lizzie, the coke whore, who's undercover, who's really a coke whore. Ah! One of us is getting rich! Oh, no. Terrence Howard says that. His one fucking line in the whole movie. He was there for the paycheck, obviously. Somebody's getting rich. Rest of us are getting dead. Fuck you! No! Fuck you! No! Fuck you! Fuck you! You did it! I fucking kill all you motherfucker! That's the dialogue in this film, which I'll get into. Lizzie, oh, I'm fucking Terrence Howard. What? Monster, what? You fucking, and he says the C word, which I'm not going to repeat. Arnold, I told you, you did not listen to me. Put the cookie down. No, I wish Arnold would have said that in this movie. It would have been better than the dialogue in this movie. So Grinder, who's Joe Manganiello, that's his name, I couldn't say it. He's the dude with the weird, like, the dreadlocks and the beard. That guy, yeah, with the dreadlocks. I think he's got, like, a beard thing going on. You know how people put, like, rubber bands? I don't even fucking care, to be honest. I don't care. So, he calls Olivia Williams, and they meet in, like, a car in the middle of a rainstorm for some reason, and he's like, you know, we stole the money because we were going to go to Mexico and we were going to pay off everybody and go find these guys that killed John's family. So Olivia Williams knows what's going on now, so they all meet in a restaurant. And they're gonna, you know, he's like, I'm sorry, you know, I had to do it. And Arnold's like, it's okay, he's like, I would have done the same thing. You know, if you didn't do it, I was gonna do it. And I like that, because he's actually like, you know, we fucked up, we were wrong, we took this money, you know, now we gotta fix this. You know, our team is dying, we gotta fix this. So they sit down, and then Grindr gets shot in the head, which it looks like CGI, it didn't look practical at all. And you find out it's Lizzie with Terrence Howard's character, Sugar. And then you find, or no, later, okay, hold on. So Lizzie goes home and she's like packing her shit. And Sam Worthington is like, where are you going? I'm leaving. The fuck you are? And they get into a fight and she kills Sam Worthington. She stabs him and cuts him open with a knife. That's practical. That was all practical blood and stuff. So they go to their house because they're married. Like I said, I think I said that. If not, I'm sorry, but whatever. Fuck this movie. So they go to Monster's house, Arnold Schwarzenegger and Olivia Williams, and they look in the fridge, and he's in the fridge. All this blood starts coming out. That was practical. I appreciate that. So Lizzie calls Arnold and she's like, I'm fucked up, I'm scared, I'm sorry, where can we meet? Meet at the parking garage. So they meet at a parking garage. Arnold knows it's a fucking setup. So him and Olivia Williams go and they see them and Lizzie gets in the trunk and it was like the DC sniper thing. They cut a hole and she's shooting out of the trunk. So they start shooting at Arnold. They get into a car chase. Arnold's in the back of his truck shooting. Olivia Williams is driving. Terrence Howard's driving. They kidnap some innocent woman. So they have a car chase. I think the woman gets killed. I can't remember. Does she get killed or does, like, they throw her? I think she gets shot and they throw. I think they shoot her in the head or something. I don't even know. Who cares, right? So they try, like, they're almost out of, like, the city. So Terrence Howard crashes his car. He gets decapitated. He kills an innocent biker. Lizzie's all fucked up. Arnold and Olivia Williams get out. She's, like, in the trunk. She's, like, laying in the trunk, dead. And, you know, she's like, I did it. We did it. We did it. We killed everyone. We killed them all. I killed my friends. Because they took my money. And Arnold's like, what? They took the money. That was my retirement fund, those fuckers. You know, whatever the dialogue is. Who cares? You know, I want my money. I kill those bastards. And Olivia Williams is like, so you stole the money? And then Arnold's like, no, I did it. I took the money. Which again, that was a surprise. I did not expect Arnold to steal the money in this movie. That was a surprise. That was definitely a surprise. I did not expect that to happen when I saw this movie in the theater. But Lizzie like goes for her gun and Arnold shoots her in self-defense, which is different on the deleted scenes, which I'll get into. And Olivia Williams is like, what the fuck is she talking about? Like, what's going on? And Arnold's like, just walk away. Just be a good girl and walk away. So Arnold, like, does it, and I'm going to reference The Crow here. Arnold does that walking against the wind shit. I hate when they do that. He just fucking disappears out of nowhere. I guess Arnold's a Power Ranger. I guess he teleported, or he's a Ninja Turtle, and he went in the sewers because he's nowhere to be found. So Arnold, like, fucks off. And then it's like a couple weeks later and he's in Mexico and Arnold all of a sudden becomes the Lone Ranger because he's wearing a cowboy hat and everything, which was kind of weird. So Arnold goes to Mexico and he takes the money that he stole and he goes to this cop that I guess he knows and, you know, he's like, you know, he has a picture of the guy that killed his family from the video. And he's like, where is this guy? And he's just sitting there. And the cop's just sitting there. And Arnold's like, okay. He just starts putting money up. Is that enough? The guy doesn't say anything. Is that enough? Oh, you want more? You want more? You want more? So Arnold gives, like, most of this money to this guy. And then he tells him. Like, he's like, okay, I'll tell you. But it's in Spanish. Like, he says it in Spanish. So he, like, opens up a drawer and he pulls out, like, this folder. And he's like, here, you know, this is where he is. This is what his name is. So then Arnold goes to this bar and he, like, I thought this was weird because, like, the whole bar is full of this, I guess, like, this guy's a cartel leader or something. And the guy, like, the bar is full of all of his people. And Arnold's, like, sitting off to the side with the, he's, like, got a cowboy hat and stuff on. And he's just sitting there drinking tequila. And I'm thinking, like, they know who Arnold is. They know what he looks like. Why would they just not kill him? You know, I just thought that was weird. Like, why would they not kill Arnold right away? They know what he looks like. They fucking killed his family. You know? Whatever. So Arnold's sitting there. He's drinking whiskey. He's smoking a cigar. The guy comes in with his goons. Excuse me. So he waits for a little bit. The guy does like a bunch of cocaine and he goes in the bathroom with a hooker. So Arnold just gets up and walks through the bar. Again, no one knows that Arnold's in the bar. No one knows that, you know, a white guy, you know, this is in Mexico. No one noticed this white guy in this bar by himself, dressed up like a cowboy. No one notices Arnold. So he gets up and he goes in the bathroom. He locks the door. I think he goes to the bath. I think he takes a piss or something, or he's in the stall or something before. I think. I don't remember. I've watched this movie. I've seen this movie 3 times and I don't remember. I don't, whatever. So the guy comes in with the hooker and they're like doing drugs and they're getting ready to have sex and everything. So Arnold, like, pushes the hooker out of the way. I think he knocks her down or something. And, like, the bathroom, it's the big, like, tub-sized urinal, like the old-school ones, and it's full of ice. So Arnold, like, hits the guy with this gun. He has a .45, which I thought was cool because it was old-school. He hits the guy with the gun. He puts the guy's head in the urinal, and he's like, you know, you remember me? You know, you killed my family. He's like, no. He's like, no, don't kill me. He's like, no, that was it. That was the last thing I did. He's like, what are you going to do? You're going to kill me and your whole family? And my family? You're going to kill my family? And Arnold's like, I could, but I'm not like you. And he just puts the gun to the guy's head and shoots him. And it's CGI. Because that I would understand because you have a gun, a real gun with blanks pointed at some. That I understand why they would do CGI. That's safety reasons. You know, people get. Brandon Lee got killed, you know, I understand why they would do that, you know, that is completely understandable. But, so Arnold shoots this guy in the head, like I said, I think he knocked the hooker down or something. He opens the door, he throws a flashbang in there, and remember, he only has one gun. So he goes out and he starts shooting everybody. He kills, I think, all the drug dealer guys. He reloads, he like hides under the bar, he comes back up, he shoots all these guys and women, because there's a couple women in there that he kills. Then he sits down, he looks at his chest and he got shot. So I guess he dies, I don't know. So he drinks, I think it's either tequila or whiskey. So he starts drinking the whiskey. He lights up a cigar, and he's got this look on his face like, that wasn't worth it. Like in Street Night with Jeff Speakman at the end, when Wolfgang Bodersen's like, was it worth it? And Jeff Speakman's like, that's how Arnold looks. He's like, I think he even like shakes his head no. And you hear these sirens coming, and then the movie just ends. Does Arnold die? Does Arnold get arrested? Is he a hero? Like, what the fuck happened? Like, what happened? That's my question to the action genre and this movie. What happened? The movie got negative reviews, thank God. IGN gave it a 7 out of 10. They said Sabotage is far more effective than its action-centric trailers have suggested, with the film more a mystery thriller that actually offers Arnold Schwarzenegger and the cool ensemble a chance to act and not shoot guns. What cool ensemble? Everyone else in this movie sucked except Arnold. Terrence Howard was there for a paycheck. That's it. The budget was $35 million. It only made $17 million. Thank God, because it sucked. Opened 7th place in its opening weekend. The worst opening weekend for Arnold in 30 years. Good, because this movie fucking sucked. I know what you're saying. Why do you own the Blu-ray DVD combo pack then? Because I liked Arnold in the movie. I can watch it for Arnold. Other than that, nothing. And you know what was probably the most embarrassing thing about this movie was when Arnold Schwarzenegger went on Monday Night Raw with Hulk Hogan and promoted the movie. That was fucking embarrassing. Yeah, I'm here on Monday Night Raw with Sabotage and Hulk Hogan. It was fucking awful. But the cast was horrible. I did not give a shit about any of the cast members. The movie lied. The trailers lied. The trailers made it look like something like Commando. No. I knew, like, the first scene of the movie, you see Arnold sitting there, and it's shaky cam. It's like this. And Arnold's watching this video of his wife getting tortured, and he's all upset. And then you see him washing his hands, and then it's like, you know, 8 months later or whatever. I knew from then, I'm like, they fucking lied. Because I went with a friend of mine. I think we went opening day. It was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We went to a matinee because we did a double feature that day. And it was me and him. There was a couple and I think a woman was in there. So there was only like 5 people in the whole theater. At 4 o'clock in the afternoon on a Friday. Now, granted, the night showings might have been more people, but I'm not surprised because this movie sucked. Now, I'd rather watch this than Terminator 3 or Red Sonja or Hercules in New York because I can actually enjoy Arnold in this movie. You know, and the movie has some practical makeup effects. That surprised me. I'm like, oh, wow, you know, that was a surprise. Arnold's got all these pictures in the movie. Those are actual pictures of him, which I thought was cool. I didn't like the fucking haircut that Arnold has. Like, what the fuck is that about? And I didn't like his tattoos. I don't have a problem with tattoos. I like tattoos. I would never get a tattoo. That's just me. But Arnold just looks so out of place with tattoos. And even when he had his damn hoodie, like, I didn't care for his hoodie. Like, why is Arnold wearing a hoodie? You know, I didn't care about, you know, Lizzie, the Kokor, who's undercover, who's really a Kokor. I didn't fucking care about her. You're supposed to be a DEA agent and you're a drug addict? That makes a lot of fucking sense. Didn't care about Sam Worthington. I didn't care about anybody else in this movie except Arnold. I did not care for Arnold's team. I was happy when they all got killed because to me, they were rejects from a Rob Zombie film. They were dumb, stupid, ignorant, fucking rednecks that all they did was curse. And I know I've been cursing throughout this whole video because it's out of anger and frustration, but they curse in this movie like they were giving candy away. And the dialogue in this movie fucking sucked. First of all, the movie opened up with a stupid fart joke. Oh, who dropped ass? Ugh. And then what's he say? He's like, oh, what is that? That's brisket or whatever. Oh my God, you dropped ass. And then Arnold's like, shut the fuck up! Thank you, Arnold. You know, that's all you heard in this movie. Fuck, fuck, motherfucker, fucking, fuck this, fuck that, fuck you, fuck her, fuck them, motherfucker, fuck, 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 motherfucker, fucking, fuck this, fuck that, fuck him, fuck her, fuck them, fuck all of it, fuck, fuck, fuck. That's all you heard in this movie. I got tired of hearing it. Rob Zombie must have wrote this film, because that's all I heard in the Halloween movie. Stupid, like the one, what was the one quote? That's what happens when you go fingering the devil's pussy. Oh, because that makes total fucking sense. Total fucking sense. Don't blow your balls off. Don't worry, they're made of brass. Are they your wife's? As big as your wife's? Yeah, Lizzie. Sweetheart, baby, honey, sugar. Yeah, like when they go into the safe house. Liquid meth. Oh, hell yeah. You're one fucked up bitch. Yeah, because she's doing fucking coke and meth and everything, and you're a fucking DEA agent. And Arnold, fuck you, asshole. I mean, okay, yeah, he said fucking all of his other movies, but fuck you, fuck this. I didn't fucking take the money. We're not the fucking team anymore. I don't fucking understand. Do I blame Arnold? I don't know. And the whole fucking, like, the scene where they're in, like, their like, hangout. Was that a dick? Oh, it looks like a dick. It is a dick. Oh, it's not a dick. Really? 2014 Arnold Schwarzenegger films have come to dick and fart jokes? Like all the other movies that come out now? Like fucking the new Ninja Turtles movie? More on that later. Yeah, they go to a fucking strip club and they're acting like assholes. And the security guard's like, you gotta get down from there. No, fuck you. And they beat the security guard up and they're all sitting there laughing. What the fuck? Like, that makes no sense whatsoever. And the whole thing about, like, you know, oh, someone's framing the cartel. That did not make any sense. Like, it would have been more mysterious if the cartel had not been involved. See, because that's making you think that this movie is, you know, the drug cartel is trying to get revenge. No, it's not the drug cartel. You find out it's fucking Lizzie and Terrence Howard. So, like, that made no sense. Like, that's like a huge continuity error. That doesn't make sense. Why would you kill the cartel members, like, and then they think it's them and it's not them, and then you're planting body, like, I don't know, like, Skip Woods cannot write. Hitman, I'm sorry, sucked. X-Men Origins Wolverine, I liked it, but it wasn't that good. The A-Team was alright. A Good Day to Die Hard, my biggest problem with that was the direction and the fucking CGI and the fucking shaky cam. I like the idea, but the script could have been better. I know they're doing a remake of Hitman and this guy's writing it. Whoopee fucking do. I don't care. And this script sucked. David Ayer, I'm sorry. On the DVD, there's a making of, oh, he's all about realism and this and that, and he was actually a cop and he knows his shit. Obviously not, because this movie sucked. He was in the Navy, okay? He was in the Navy. But still, I don't give a fuck about this script. This script sucked. Arnold needs to pick better scripts or retire. I hate to say it, folks, but I don't have any faith left in action films. After this movie and Bullet to the Head and Expendables 3 and, to an extent, Die Hard 5, which is the least my least favorite of the franchise, I like it, you know, but I don't understand. I don't know what the fuck happened to the action genre, and I don't know what the fuck happened to these stars, because they're all fucking crazy now. You know, Bruce Willis is going on all these fucking interviews, acting like a dickhead, and Arnold, I don't know, he's sleeping with the maid. Stallone has lost his fucking mind, he forgot to take his medication. I don't know, Jackie Chan, oh, I'm going to retire. Now I'm not going to retire. I'm not going to make action films anymore. I'm going to make some action films. I don't want to do Expendables because I just want to make Rush Hour 4, but have it be me and Sly. I don't want all these other people in this movie. I don't like any of these other people in this movie. I'm going to do a movie like Rush Hour with Chris Tucker, but it's not Rush Hour. Van Damme, unfortunately, Van Damme stuck in direct-to-video hell. Granted, most of the ones he's made, I've liked. Steven Seagal, I'm not even going to talk about Steven Seagal because I know I'm the only person that likes Steven Seagal. Dolph Lundgren, I feel terrible for Dolph Lundgren. Why did he get screwed over? The Rock, okay, The Rock's doing Hercules, which I'd like to see, and The Fast and Furious, but I'd rather The Rock make more movies like Walking Tall or The Rundown, because I like those movies, and I think those were his best movies. I liked Faster. I didn't see Snitch. I didn't see Empire State. Maybe I'll check those out. I gotta stop soon because my voice is shot from this and the fucking Terminator 3 rant. But on this Blu-ray, you have deleted scenes and alternate endings. And the way they do it is stupid because one of the deleted scenes is actually the first part of the alternate ending, but they present it differently. Okay, in this original ending, and this movie was supposed to be like 3 hours. Thank God it's not 3 hours, because I would have fucking slammed my head through the wall if I had to sit through this piece of shit for 3 hours. That's just me. Okay, the alternate ending, Lizzie is not the one behind the killings. She's about to reveal that Arnold, like, you know, she didn't do it. So Arnold just shoots her. And the cop, Olivia Williams, is like, why'd you do that? She was going for her gun. No, she wasn't. Yes, she was. Arnold just fucking disappears. And her partner shows up. And Arnold, and she's like, where is he? Where's Arnold? Well, I don't know. He just disappeared. What the fuck did you do? I don't know. I know where the money is. So they go to Arnold's house. And the money's there. The money is out in fucking the lake. So they go out there. They steal Arnold's boat. And they have like a tracker or something. Like they can tell like what's in the water. I don't even know. And I don't care. So they find it. She dives down. She finds the money. Because they put like weight. He put weights on it. So like she's coming up. And you see like this flashlight. And you see it's a guy in a cop uniform, in a cop, like, jacket, because I guess it's cold. So, Olivia Williams' partner, Jackson's his name, he's like, oh, hey, what, you know, what took you guys so long to get here? Because, like, there's cops there, and so, like, you see this flashlight, and then you just hear a gunshot, and he gets shot and killed, and it's Arnold. So, you know Arnold, now you know Arnold's the bad guy. Arnold killed everybody. Arnold stole the money. Arnold is the bad guy in this movie. So Arnold starts like shooting in the water. And like Olivia Williams is down there. And then Arnold gets in the water to find her. They have a fight. And like Arnold beats her up. And she gets away. And he's like, you fucking bitch. You fucking whore. For whatever reason. So Arnold gets the money. And goes in the car, like, there's these cops come up, and he kills these cops. Like, he gets on, like, he's shooting at him, and then he jumps on top of the car with a shotgun, and he kills, like, it was like two cops. So Arnold's killed like three cops at this point and everybody else. Whatever. So he gets in the car to get away, and Olivia Williams just pops out of nowhere. And, you know, she's like, why? You know, why did everyone have to die? And he's like, they killed my family. He's like, they killed my family. She's like, they wouldn't let me go get revenge. They wouldn't let me do this. They killed my family. And he has like an assault rifle in the car. And she's like, put your hands up. Put your hands up now. I'm putting my hands up. Put them up. Put them up now. I'm putting my hands up. And he goes to reach for it, and she shoots him. She kills Arnold, and the movie ends. In the other ending, pretty much the same, except Arnold gets in the car, and she shows up again. And she's like, you know, why? Why did you do this? And he's like, well, they betrayed me. One of my team members betrayed me. They sold me out. They're responsible for my family's death. Of course, we don't know fucking who. So, killed everybody, and they obviously couldn't tell in the other parts of the movie. So, he shoots Olivia Williams and kills her, and he drives away with the money. And then I guess it picks up when he goes to Mexico. And the producers are like, no, we don't want Arnold to be the bad guy. So, then they changed it to where Lizzie was behind it, and Arnold took the money, but he didn't intend for everybody to get killed, you know, so he feels guilty, you know. And then there's other deleted scenes on here which were fucking pointless. There was the one after Olivia Williams and Arnold have sex. You see Arnold naked in the bed, and Olivia Williams throws a condom in the toilet. Pointless as shit. There's a couple scenes where there's like a subplot where this girl gets kidnapped, and Arnold, like, apparently Arnold went and killed the guy, but he didn't. No, I'm sorry. Olivia Williams is trying to get, like, she thinks the dad did it. So they go to his trailer, and he's like, well, he's like, where the fuck is my daughter? And, like, more stupid redneck shit. And then it's fucking racist because Olivia Williams' partner's black, and he's like, oh, you bring that black SOB. I'm like, wow, way to not be racist in this scene. And then there's another scene where they're like looking for the body, and they find her, and Olivia Williams is crying because this girl died, and then you find out it was the dad or something. I don't know. It was pointless. Like, what the fuck did this have to do with the movie? Nothing. Why was it included on the deleted scenes? I don't know, and I don't care. This movie should have been simple. It should have been basic. It should have been something like Commando or Predator or something simple. Arnold and his team bust the drug cartel. They capture the drug lord. They confiscate the money. They're heroes. They get awards and everything. Everything's fine. They go on vacation. Everything's good. They come back. The drug lord escapes from prison. The money's gone. And Arnold, you know, we risk our lives. You know, we're not expendable. You dropped us in the meat grinder. You know, like in Predator. One by one, the team starts getting killed. And they're trying to find out who did it. You know, they're trying to find out these guys. They have some shootouts with the cartel. They get some information. Arnold's family gets kidnapped. Arnold's like, that's it. Fuck this. I'm going to Mexico. If you want to come, we will go. I'm going to get these motherfuckers. They go to Mexico. They go to take out the cartel in like this big like mansion. One of the team members betrays Arnold. They capture Arnold. Arnold gets out, you know, all the other team members get killed. Arnold is just doing the one-man army thing like Commando. He starts killing the drug cartel. He kills the person that betrayed his family and him. He rescues his family, and he goes home. That's what this movie should have been. How fucking hard is that? Apparently that is so hard to do. But anyway, guys, I don't know anymore. Like I said, the action genre is dead. It is dead in the water. I'd like to see November Man. I'd like to see The Equalizer with Denzel Washington. But other than that, I have no faith in the action genre anymore. I don't care. I don't care about Rambo 5. Because Stallone's lost his fucking mind. Which I'll... When I do... That's down the road. But... I don't care about anything that's coming out in theaters. I'll keep watching Van Damme's films. Because Van Damme actually gives a shit. And he's trying. Seagal... I mean, I still like Seagal. I'll check his movies out. That's just me. I know people don't like Seagal. I know I'm the only one. Dolph Lundgren, same deal. I'll still watch his movies because he still cares. But Arnold, I don't know. After this, I don't know. I don't know anymore. I liked Escape Plan. I really enjoyed The Last Stand. But I don't know anymore. I don't want to know anymore. I know they're doing another Conan. To me, whatever. I don't care, honestly. I don't know. I don't know anymore. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching the Arnold Schwarzenegger reviews. I hope that you enjoyed them all. If you'd like to go back and check them out again, feel free. I do have two more videos with Arnold planned. One video I'd like to show off my collection of Arnold movies and memorabilia. The other one, that's going to be a little bit of a surprise. After that, I am going to review Escape Plan and the Expendables film, since Arnold is technically in those movies. So I'll review those, so you can look forward to seeing that. And then I don't know after that. I don't know what I'm going to do. I do have a VHS, DVD, and Laserdisc update, and a wrestling VHS and DVD update already filmed, so I'll upload those after I'm done with the reviews. And then I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do from there. But anyway, guys, I hope that you enjoyed all these reviews. I'm sorry that I'm losing my voice now. But that's what happens when you film a couple rants. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed all of the reviews. And take care. Bye-bye.